Hello, welcome back to the Emanation. It's time we had a little talk. The third issue of the Emanation print edition contains almost no material written by myself, which is the opposite of the previous two editions, which I wrote entirely alone. Lots of people have contributed to this new issue, including people here, not here, there, in Asheville, and also people from all over the place, worldwide actually, contributing to the Emanation off of YouTube. So this is the first time that I started to see signs of the two things kind of coming together, the videos and the print thing. And people have expressed a lot of interest in the print thing, both in reading it and in wanting to write for it. So we need to talk about what writing for the Emanation is all about. Basically, if you write something that sounds like you went to school and you know how to write clear common English, I'll print it. If it's relevant to chaos magic, I'm happy to hear about it. Submissions don't have to be of any particular type. We can mainly print reviews because we're a publication geared towards solitary practitioners, so print materials are pretty heavy on our list of needs. Or in other sources of information as well. So you can review pretty much anything you want. You want to review a magazine, a website, a book, review any sort of materials you come across, a company that makes good, say, ritual paraphernalia or tarot cards or anything that you feel like is relevant and that you found to be useful, feel free to write about it. And that could be a lecture, a workshop, something you've actually experienced, whatever. They don't have to be anything new or current. Just please let us know how old it is. I've read a lot of books from around the 20s and the 30s, so I try to point that out, that this is not a current book when I do that. Our reviews are based on a 5-point scale. 5 is the best possible book on or material on the subject. 1 is the worst possible material on the subject. We don't use 1/2-point ratings. It's either a 3 or a 4. It's no 3.5. We try to focus on stuff that's particularly good. I don't want to fill up the Emanation with bad reviews of stuff that nobody wants to look at. I'd rather talk about what's good and highlight the best things. The only time I really want to focus on a bad review is if it's something from a popular writer or somebody who's got a reputation for making good stuff and they put out something that's just not up to par. Or I also have a bit of an axe to grind about a certain class of publications that have come out since the turn of the new century and have become very popular, particularly on Amazon.com. And what I'm talking about is there's a flood of small little paperbacks that are less than 100 pages long that have got giant type, lots of illustrations that don't highlight anything in the text. And they're less than 100 pages. They cost about $15 plus $4 for the shipping. They're total ripoffs. The material in these publications that I've seen is almost universally taken, derived from, and sometimes even plagiarized from the works of Phil Hine, Peter Carroll, a little bit of Robert Anton Wilson. I see it's just rehash. It's hack writing and it's bad. And if you've come across one of these books and spent your good money on... Think of it this way. If you work for minimum wage, which in the United States is about $7.50, and you buy a book that's worth 2 hours of your hard labor, actually probably more than that by the time they've taken out taxes, you may have to spend 3 hours at your job to afford a book. And you sit down and you read it, and A, it takes you less time to read it than it took you to earn the money to buy it, and you can tell that the author didn't spend very much time writing it. It's worth pointing out. This is not a good material, and to stay away from it. So that particular type of publication, I don't mind putting bad review of in our paper, our newsletter. Otherwise, I don't really want to talk too much about bad stuff. Let's see. Non-review articles are welcome. You can write pretty much about anything you want, an opinion, an experience, a how-to technique, letters to the editor, questions, all kinds of things are welcome. We're trying to stimulate conversation and discussion and stuff, and contrary viewpoints are welcome. Just pretty much pitch in anything you want, as long as it's relevant and of good quality. All of our submissions are subject to editing. If you write something, I don't change your words. I don't change what you say. I simply maybe correct your spelling or your formatting. And the most common edit that I have made, and I've had to do this with everything that's sent in, is shortening sentences. The people who write have written things for the Emanation have proven themselves to be quite good, competent writers, and they write nice, long, technically correct, beautiful literary sentences. And the thing I have to point out is that periodical is journalism, it is not literature, and please try to write things that are fairly quick and to the point. The most common edit that I do is changing a comma into a period and then capitalizing the next word. Don't try to impress me with your vocabulary or anybody else with your vocabulary and how well you can construct a long sentence using commas and semicolons to fit six parenthetical phrases into a single sentence. I'd rather make a paragraph out of that. So anyway, no run-on sentences is basically what I'm saying. Writers don't get paid, although I will, because there's no money to pay you. No budget. Publish the Emanation out of my pocket. We have bought a printer, which is now a dedicated printer, strictly for this publication. So paper and ink costs are coming directly out of our non-existing budget. And so nobody's getting paid because there's no money to pay him. However, if you write something, I will send you a complimentary copy of the Emanation that contains your submission. That's only proper policy for any respectable publication, so I will give you a copy for free. Because of that, the cost of publication and the fact that the Emanation is getting longer, the new issue is 6 pages long. I intend to have a 10-page publication by the 10th issue. But the price necessarily goes up as we have to print more pages. And I want to put a cap on that. And it necessarily will stabilize as more people are becoming interested and submissions and subscriptions are starting to come in. So at the current time, the first two issues were $2. The new issue, the current issue, is $3 because it's longer. And I would like to have a goal for a minimum of 10 pages for a maximum of $5 by the 10th issue. That's my editorial publication goal. So the price is going up, but it won't continue to go up, is basically what I'm getting at. Subscriptions are based on the idea that we put out 6 issues per year. That's an objective. It may not become a reality because in the beginning I was writing everything myself and it took a long time. So now that people are writing it for me and 3's done and 4 is half done, just like that, they may come up more frequently. So if you subscribe to the Emanation, you're going to get 6 a year. Okay, a year's subscription will be at least 6 issues. If we don't put out 6 issues that year, we will extend your subscription until you have received 6 issues. If we put out more than 6 issues in a year's time, you get however many we put out. I hope that made sense. Let's see. That's about it for that. I've really enjoyed talking to everybody, and I've enjoyed the fact that the Emanation got written very quickly, and all I had to do was basically a bunch of editing, and not much of that even. So feel free to throw in anything you want to. If I don't put it in the current issue, it may be because I've just got too much of a particular type of thing in the issue that I'm currently writing on, and so I may want to put it off to a later issue where we're not so one-sided. I want to have a balanced thing. I don't want to have dedicated issues. So that's writing for the Emanation, and if you have something you want to contribute, feel free to send it to me, and I'll look at it, and we'll put it in there. Thanks a lot.